Fanning the flames, as I said before, it's pretty windy, and now we're covered in smoke. So what I've done is literally with my large stick at arm's length with my gloves on, I've just moved the fire to spread the logs apart to get so there's not enough fuel going through each of the logs. So as you can see, it started to smoke. The larger logs have gone out quickly, the smaller ones are still fighting it a little bit. So I'm just going to move them around a little bit, just moving the embers a little bit that are nice and hot, making sure that it's cooling down. So once the flames have gone out, I'll then douse some water on it and let it cool down, and then we'll just sweep it away. Just gotta make sure it's all gone out. There's one still just going here. So I'm just gonna move it a little bit more so all the embers are sort of going out. And it's hot. Yeah. So although the flames may go, the embers are still alight with redness, which means there's heat there. And even when the embers have gone, then it's not so you should never underestimate the heat that is still involved. So you can see it's smoking now, there's no fuel going through, the wind's died down, so the flames, that's right down the flames, it's just glowing. Okay. But as I say, once even the flames are gone, then it's so important not to underestimate it. So the big logs can stay in there. Once the water is obviously added to ashes and embers that are warm, the smoke will go up in a big way. But even now, if the wind blew, I would say some of these would probably relight a little bit again. You can hear it's popping away, so I'm just going to leave it a little bit longer, then douse it with water, which is in the bucket here. Sure it's really, really wet and not hot. Okay, so you can see the smoke has really, really died down. Still a few embers there. Takes a while. Slab underneath, so that's what the hissing noise is. A bit of heat coming from it, you can see the smoke coming out of it still. A bit more. It's so quick that the fires can gain heat as well. So I've got my brush, so in a second all I'm going to do is get a sheet and brush the leftovers out onto it. So it's clear for the next time we use it. I'm going to leave the bigger logs in there, but just the small pieces of ash. Just sweep it in. my pit here is completely empty. The two things left are the two big logs, which I'm going to leave in there. Nice and cool, not hot. Place it all back, so it's safe. Okay, so that's it. I've done the fire, so you've seen how it's lit and how we actually light it here. Obviously, as I said, we use other tools and other equipment and other natural resources once we're in our forest setting. We've doused it, put the fire out, and then cleaned the majority away, which is that in the pot. Okay, so thank you very much.